In a stadium where the Taliban used to execute women, some among the dusty floors and broken mirrors have fought their way to a better life. This is Sadaf Rahimi. You can see here how her future as Afghanistan's first female boxer to fight at the Olympics might have been obvious when, aged 11, she threw her first punch.
The first person I hit was my 18-year-old cousin. We got in a little scuffle and then he said I should be a boxer.
It's tough just to be a woman in Afghanistan, tougher still to fight in a traditionally male sport. But now Sadaf faces the hardest challenge, and that's to get ready to fight and win against the world's best.
A wild card from the Olympic Committee has fast-forwarded her to the London finals in August. But now she must overcome the real hurdle of training without a boxing ring, proper gear, or enough free time.
We can only train 1 hour a day, that's it. It's not enough to prepare for London. Other teams train 3 times a day, and the equipment we have is pretty inadequate. I even had to buy my own socks.
She wants expert help in Dubai or India with the same advantages her competitors will have, but this is Afghanistan, where money is too often in all the wrong places. So they're left hoping for a sponsor to even things out.
We would like a sponsor who has a good name in sport. Just give us a chance. And she is the perfect example.
For these girls, it's not just the punches that can harm. In a society many fear will grow even more conservative as NATO leaves, Sadaf's father's got anonymous phone threats that meant she stayed away from the gym for a month. Great disadvantage, but also determination from someone who says she's never hit anyone in anger. Well, not yet, anyway. Nick Paton Walsh, CNN, Kabul.